everybody. In this lesson, I'm going to teach how to calculate volume. And we can separate into two groups, object in defined shape and object in irregular shape to calculate volume. First, measurement of volume in three-dimensional regular solid, and the unit of volume is meter cube. And how do we convert from meter cube to centimeter cube? And as you remember, 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. If we get the its cube, this is 1 meter cube equal to 10 to 2 out of 3 centimeter cube. 1 meter cube equal to 10 to 6 centimeter cube. And another important conversion, 1 liter means 1 decimeter cube. And as you remember, 1 meter equal to 10 decimeter. If we get cube of both sides, 1 meter cube equal to 10 to 3 decimeter cube. So 1 decimeter cube is 1 liter, so that 1 meter cube equal to 10 to 3 liter. Yes, we can continue. It can be cubic meter, where do we use volumes, and it can be any liquid inside a bottle, or that can be cubic centimeter. If it's in defined shape, it can be sphere, we use this formula. If it is a cube, we use a out of 3 formula. And if it's a cylinder, we use this formula to calculate its volume. And if it's a rectangular prism, it is A times B times height. Yes, we can see them inside here. That can be cube, rectangular prism, and sphere. That can be right circular cylinder, right circular cone, and right square pyramid. These are the calculation of volumes. Yes, if our object is irregular solid, what do we do? We have two methods to measure volume of irregular solid. The volume of irregular solid is determined by using displacement method. Yes, we are going to use displacement cup. In this method, the solid is fully or wholly immersed in a liquid, and the volume of liquid displaced is measured. This method operates on the principle that a body fully or wholly immersed in a fluid liquid displays its own volume. And the requirement used to measure of the volume of irregular solid, measuring cylinder, water, and piece of thin silk thread. And second, measuring cylinder, overflow displacement can be used, water, and again silk thread. Yes, we can see. How do we do it? We use measuring cylinder, the first method, fill measuring cylinder with water and record initial reading. Then we put the object inside water and fully immerse. Then shake it gently to remove any air bubbles. Then record final reading, and the difference between initial reading and the final reading is going to give volume of irregular object. We can see on figure, we have measuring cylinder, we put water in on that level, so that we are going to read initial value. Then we put irregular object, and there will be difference between initial level and the final level, so the difference between initial level and the final level gives the volume of irregular object. And how can we use overflow can? Yes, we can full overflow can with water until water flows out through the spot and wait until the water ceases dripping and then place dry measuring cylinder below the spot. Then tie the irregular object with a piece of thin silk thread and lower it carefully into the water and overflow can until it is fully immersed. Then shake it gently to remove any air bubble and wear until the water ceases dripping into the measuring cylinder. Record the volume of displaced water in the cylinder. Yes, this volume in displaced water cylinder is the volume of irregular object. Let us see it on figure. We have overflow can. It is fully up to spot. Then we put irregular object inside the water and fully immerse. Then some water will flow to measuring cylinder because the irregular object take place inside the water, and we are going to read the value in displaced water in measuring cylinder. This volume equal to volume of irregular shape. Yes, thank you for watching this video. We can measure volume by measuring cylinder or overflow can. Next video, we are going to define how to calculate density.